are glad that you're here. It's going to be a great morning. We get to celebrate Jesus, and the kiddos get to come out and do their Christmas play for us. It's going to be a great morning. Amen. Well, let's start off with prayer, and then we're going to sing a little bit before we hand it over to the kids. Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we're so grateful, so thankful for this day. Father, we thank you for your presence. We remember that Jesus is the reason for the season. And Father, we celebrate Jesus today, and we're so thankful that Jesus was born for us, Father. We are forever grateful, forever thankful. Father, we thank you for your presence in this service today. And Father, minister to each and every heart today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Let's say this together. Joy to the world. Sing.
Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven, heaven and nature.
Let's say that again. Joy to the world.
Joy to the world.
He rules the world.
He rules the world with truth and grace and makes the nations rule. The glories of his righteousness and wonders of his love and wonders of his love.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's sing this together. Oh, come, all ye faithful.
Oh, come, all ye.
Oh,
of angels.
Sing, choirs of angels, sing in exultation. Sing, O ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest.
Thank you. Exalt you in this place right now. Hallelujah, Jesus, we honor you. We celebrate you this Christmas season. God, we're so grateful. We're so thankful for all that you've done. You are wonderful. Counselor, mighty God, Prince of Peace, everlasting Father, and we worship and honor your name today, God. Hallelujah. Father, I pray for each and every person under the sound of my voice today, God. I thank you and I praise you, God, for your goodness. I thank you, Lord, for your healing power, your strength, God, flowing into people this Christmas season. God, for the peace of God that passes all understanding. In Jesus' name. Father, for those that may be hurting or discouraged or things, challenges going on in their lives, Father, I thank you that you are peace to the storm right now. In Jesus' name, we declare the peace of God to the storm. In Jesus' name, the strength of God, the wisdom of God for those that don't know what to do. Lord, that you would give them wisdom and lead and guide and direct their every step. Father, you're so good. You're so faithful. Father, we thank you for your presence. Lord, we thank you for your presence. God, you're so good. Lord, for those that may need healing in their bodies today, Father, we thank you that where the presence of the Lord is, there's healing. Father, the word of God says that you sent your word and you healed us and delivered us from destruction. So, Father, we thank you for your healing power flowing into bodies today. And to those that are watching on Facebook Live, Father, we thank you and we praise you for your healing power flowing. In Jesus' name, Father, you're so good. You're so good. You're so faithful. Father, we thank you for your presence. Father, we thank you. We praise you. Hallelujah. Isn't it good to come and to gather with other believers to worship God? There's no better way. No better way to celebrate this Christmas than to gathering together worshiping him. Amen. Because remember, Jesus is the reason for the season. Amen. Well, turn around, greet somebody, let them know you're glad to see them today, and then you may be seated. The Lord. Well, welcome this morning to Midwest Believers Church. We are glad that you're here. I see some new faces today. Welcome, welcome, welcome. If this is your first time here and you did not stop by the Welcome Center, that's the big thing in the center of the lobby, please do so as you leave. We've got a free gift for you. We just want to say thank you for coming and worshiping with us today. And just to let you know that we are glad that you're here today. Amen. It's going to be a great service. For those of you that don't know, my name is Rhonda. This is my husband, Trent, and we pastor here at Midwest Believers Church, and it is an honor to have you here with us today. This is our kids' Sunday, and they have been practicing the last couple of months, preparing for a Christmas play, and they always get excited about doing this. And so we're excited to be able to support them and encourage them. And after the play is over, be sure and let the kids know when you see them that they did a great job today. Give them a compliment, encourage them, because they get really excited about this. I know when my girls were little and got to be in it, it was a big deal. It was a big Sunday for them. And so let them know how blessed you were by it. A few quick announcements. Due to the holidays, we have some changes in our schedule. There will be no Monday night prayer meeting tomorrow night. There's no Wednesday night midweek service this week due to the holiday. And then next Sunday, there is actually no service on Christmas Day. What we're doing, we're going to move our service up a day early and have a Saturday morning Christmas Eve service. And so if this is your first time here and you don't have anywhere to go worship next weekend, please come join us. We're going to have an hour candlelight service. We'll have communion. It'll be a really nice service. So that'll be Saturday at 10:30, and we will not have an early service that day. So it's one service only at 10:30. So please come out for that. It's going to be a really good time and a great way to kick off your Christmas Eve and Christmas. Amen. And then we'll be dropping a video on Christmas Day, just Trent and I, just a short video, just saying hello and Merry Christmas, that kind of thing, and a little scripture we're going to share with you. And so you can watch that on social media. And then also wanted to make mention, with New Year's Day around the corner, we will only have one service on New Year's Day. So there will not be a 9 a.m. service New Year's Day, a 10:30 service only. Just with New Year's Eve, most people stay up late and celebrate. And so we want you to be able to come. So we're just doing the 10:30 service only. And then the following Sunday after that, we'll be back to normal schedule. And so we've got a lot going on. If you're on social media, You can follow us on Instagram and Facebook, and we'll post these updates on there, so it'll help you stay on track for that. And then also wanted to make mention for the people that attend here, we are having an iServe banquet on Friday, January 20th. It'll be Friday evening. We did this right before COVID, and then everything kind of got shut down, and we're finally kicking it back off. And so this will be a catered meal for all of our volunteers in the church. So if you've helped or volunteer in an area regularly, or you've helped a few different times with things, we want you to come. We want to say thank you. This is always a fun night. We plan all kinds of activities. We have giveaways. We'll have a word of encouragement and an awesome meal. And so I just wanted you all to save the date. That's a Friday night, January 20th. It's going to be a great time. And so we'll have sign-up sheets out for that over the next couple weeks. But we want you to mark it on your calendar so you don't miss it. It's going to be a great time. Amen? I think that's it for me.
Praise God. God is good. Amen? Amen. If you need an offering envelope, slip your hand up in the air and the ushers will get that to you. Hallelujah. Rhonda was just talking about peace, and that's what we talked about in the, well, kind of in the first service, but we were talking about refreshing and peace, and you know, this time of the year, it was brought up to me between services, actually Jorge, but by, you know, this time of the year, the depression, things that people are going through, it seems to be accentuated or enlarged. And I want to encourage you in this, that you know what? He's the Prince of Peace, no matter what's going on around you. Amen? And so I want to encourage you in this, that this year, let this year be the most peaceful year you've ever had. Amen? You know, it may not be the most presence under the tree, the most this, all the other stuff that we judge, whether a Christmas is goodbye, just scrap that all this year and say, you know what? I'm going to walk in peace this year. So no matter what happens around me, I am going to walk and live in peace. Amen? Amen. Let's pray with this offering. Father, we thank you. We praise you for the opportunity to give, to sow into the kingdom of God. I thank you, Father, that you are the God who's more than enough. And we give you praise and we give you thanks for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. That like for a long time. Hallelujah. So good. Thank you. Bring a little bit of whatever. Amen. A little groove into our church. Amen. Hallelujah. God's so good. Amen? Yes. Amen. Well, this morning, we are so blessed. I want to take just a second just to talk about our children's ministry. And everybody that helps with that, everybody that serves back there in any area of the children's ministry. I am so glad that our children's ministry doesn't consist of babysitters. You know, that they're actually putting something into our kids.
Amen.
Amen. And Chad and Adrian Hall take the lead on that, and they do a great job. Amen. And it's not just something that they do. It's something that they're called to and that they do well. Amen. And so we appreciate it so much. And so, Chad, if you'd go ahead and come on up. Amen. Let's give Pastor Chad a hand. Thank you.
Hey, all right. Go ahead and play again. I'm going to sing that song this time. All right, go ahead. Up there. Oh, wait a minute. I better not do that. Hey, we're so glad that we're able to present this Christmas play for everybody. I think you're going to love it. What we're going to do, though, actually, is we're going to have our 3 to 6 or 3 to 5-year-old class come in. They're going to do a little presentation for you first, and then we're going to get into our Believer's Kid Christmas play, okay? So as they're coming forward, I'll look at those kids. My goodness. Right there. Next generation of faith right there. Amen. All right. Come on in, kiddos. We're going to have them all get seats. We're so happy that they're going to present this little thing. So they're going to come up here and sit down. And then our 7 to 12-year-olds. Also, due to some different situations, some people not being able to be here, some things like that, I don't want to say, I'm going to say I asked, but I really told some youth that they're going to be part of the play also. So they were, so if you see some kids and you thought, I thought they were in the youth group, they are, okay? At the last moment, I'm like, you're going to be in the play, you're going to be in the play. My daughter said, Dad, is there just one year I can actually just watch the play? And I thought she was really serious yesterday. I go, I don't want to hear anymore. You're just going to be in the play. So anyway, she's in the play also. And my son came home from college, and I said, hey, welcome home. By the way, you're going to be in the play also. So he's in the play also. That's how we roll around here. I mean, so we're really excited. But, you know, I want to just say real quick, Bronx and Lila, I know you're watching, so I want you to watch real good, and you tell me next week if we did a good job, okay? Great. You know what? We're so happy to do this. We love being children's ministers here, and it's truly an honor. And we're so excited for the kids to just present this Christmas play for you in this little presentation. So sit back, enjoy. We're going to do our thank yous afterwards, but I hope you enjoy this Christmas play.
Hi, everyone. This is our 3 to 5-year-old classroom. This is all, well, several of the students. Some of them are not here today, but I'm thankful for these 7 that did make it today. So what we're going to do, I'm just going to show you a little bit of what we do when you guys drop your kids off into class with us, okay? All right, guys. So here we go. Can anybody tell me what this is? A Bible. That's right. And we love the Bible, don't we? The Bible is full of God's words and God's promises. Can you guys pass the Bible? Can you give it a hug? Oh, my goodness. You guys can have your moms and dads read the Bible to you every day. It's full of God's words for us. Do you guys love the Bible? That's right. Whose words are in the Bible? Does anybody know?
God's words.
Can you hug the Bible? Or Eva, do you want to give the Bible a hug? Huh? What is in the Bible?
God's word.
That's right. It's full of God's words and promises. Nyla, do you want to give the Bible a hug? Yes? Okay. Awesome. We love the Bible. It is full of God's words. Okay, we have some other things. We've been talking a lot about Christmas in our class. So we have some pictures we got to talk about, right? Okay, guys. What's this a present of? Or what's this a picture of? It's a present. That's right. Did you guys know that Jesus is the best gift ever? Okay, I want you guys to say, Jesus is the best gift.
Very good.
Okay. What's this a picture of? Do you guys remember? This one is a Christmas card. Did you know people send Christmas cards to spread good news? And did you guys know that Jesus is the best news that there ever was? Okay, so I want you guys to say, I will spread good news.
Good job.
Okay, what? Now what is this a picture of? Christmas lights, that's right. Did you know that the Bible says Jesus is the light of the world? That's right. And you know what else? Jesus lives inside of you. So if Jesus is the light, that means you guys can be lights too, right? Awesome. Okay, so I want you guys to say, Jesus is the light.
Jesus is the light. Very good.
Okay, and we have... Oh, yes. I think we have a... Santa Claus has made an appearance. I think we'll get to see him a little bit later. Okay. So let's say our memory verse, okay? All right, you guys say what I say. Matthew 1:23.
They will call him
Emmanuel. Which means God is with us. Very good. Okay, now I want you guys just to say it like this in a little, little tiny voice. Matthew 1:23. They will call him Emmanuel. Which means God is with us. Very good. Okay. We have two songs we want to sing for you today. Okay, and they each made a gift to bring to their mom or to their dad or to probably mom or dad, I said. Sometimes grandmas get it and then it's like, oh, that was supposed to be for your mom and dad. So go ahead and go take it out to your mom and you guys can sit with your mom after you pass them a gift, okay? We have one for each of them to take home. She's going to give it to you. All right, and also I just wanted to say real fast while she is... passing those out. Thank you so much to all of my helpers who helped me work in the 0 to 2 year old classroom and the 3 to 5 year old classroom. I could not ever do it by myself, trust me. And like I gave almost all my workers the day off today, but it's more than just me, trust me. I think I probably have about 15 to 20 helpers who are just amazing. So if you guys are a 0 to 2 classroom helper or teacher, or a teacher or helper in the 3 to 5 year old classroom, would you guys just stand for a second? Okay, so you can tell it's not just me. So thank you guys so much for all of your help.
All right, that's so true. We want to say thank you so much. And parents, we want you to know this. that when your kids come to any of those classes, we make you a promise that we're feeding them not only, you know, gummy bears and all that stuff. We're feeding them goldfish crackers. That's what I'm looking for. We're feeding them the Word of God. And I make that commitment to you because it's so powerful and it's life-changing. And I believe what we're doing with the Heritage of Faith, when they come here, we're taking it up to the next level and the next level and the next level. So tell your friends about it. If they got kids that they're not going to a good church, we invite you here because we're going to love on them, but we're going to tell them who Jesus is and how much he loves them and what he's done for them. Amen. You know, we're so excited again. And she mentioned the 0 to 2 year old class and the 3 to 5 year old class and all the helpers. We truly mean this. The ministry is done because of you and your faithfulness to there. Because there's many times you get up and you say, oh my goodness. But you know what? One hi to a little kid, or one hug to a little kid, or one time you're telling them about Jesus, it'll change their life. I have people, I've been doing children's ministry for 22 years, and I have people, now they have kids of their own, and I'll see them and I don't even remember them. And they'll come up to me just not too long ago in a gas station and say, hey, I remember you. I went to your children's church years ago, and I remember you taught about this. And I was like, oh my goodness. It's life changing. It's the goodness of God that brings change to people's lives. So we're an extension of the goodness of God. Amen. So we're so excited to be able to present this to you. So as everybody gets ready, we're going to dim the lights in just a moment and enjoy this game show. Well, but before I do this game show, I need to pick out 3 contestants from the audience to be part of this game show.
I'll do it.
Well, I guess she's going to be one of them. Wow. Somebody got some coffee this morning. Wow. If we have any prayer warriors here, start praying now. Oh, Lord, no. Anyway. No, and then I'm going to pick out, I guess you're contestant one. I'm going to pick out another contestant. I need somebody, somebody that has a big old, one of them big old hairy beards or something. Hey, I might as well pick you. You'll do, I guess. Come on up here. You can play. You're going to be contestant number 2 for us, okay? Enjoy. Boy. You got a beard only a wife would love. Wait a minute. That's not right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick our 3rd contestant here. So I need one more contestant. I need contestant number 3. Let me see here.
I'll do it.
I guess she will do it. Come on in. All right. Well, come on up to stage. And I guess all I can say is let's turn off the lights and get ready for 4 Lies and the Truth Game Show Christmas episode.
I'm Harry Pitts. The rules are simple. We are going to show our contestants 5 scenes. 4 scenes are lies, and 1 scene is the truth. The contestants' job is to determine which scene is the truth. Sweaty, I think it's time to meet the contestants.
Yes, I agree. Contestant number 1, tell us your name.
Hello, everyone. My name is Anita Moore. I'm happy to be here because I want to win.
Yay! Thanks, Anita. Contestant number 2,
Hi, my name is Tom Manning. It's named after my two favorite NFL stars. Oh, and Green Bay Packers stink.
Everyone, I'm Honda Coin, and I am so happy to be here today. My husband, Rent, is in the audience. Hi, honey.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's look at scene one of Four Lies and the Truth. What is the true meaning of Christmas?
I told you everything I want. You better not forget.
I know. I have your list. I think there are a few more stores up here. Presents, presents, presents. It feels like it's never enough.
Hey, look out. Watch where you're going.
So sorry. It's so busy out here.
Hold on a minute. I forgot to tell you. I want a new video game, too. Please, please, please.
Oh, I hate Christmas. It's all about I want, I want, I want. It feels like it's never enough. I can't wait until it's over. Come on, I think I left a few presents back at the store.
We sure are. Remember, we are looking for the truth to the true meaning of Christmas. Contestant, let's take a look at scene two.
Are we almost there? I hate going to their house. It smells.
I know. Come on, let's get this day out of the way. Let's go to the door and knock.
Ding dong. We're over here.
Who are you?
We're your family.
Oh, is that right? Well, come on in.
Merry Christmas.
It smells.
Just try to hold your breath all day. It will be over soon.
I bet they are. Contestants, let's take a look at scene three.
Oh, Merry Christmas! Oh, Christmas, everyone! Ho, ho, ho! I'm Santa Claus! I'm practically Mr. Christmas! Ho, ho, ho!
Merry Christmas, everybody! We are busy, busy, busy!
Yes, that is right! We are so busy! In fact, in only a few couple days, I am going to travel around the world in my sleigh and deliver presents to every boy and girl. Well, we better head back to the North Pole. Let's go!
Wow, that was great. I sure hope I'm not on the naughty list.
Good luck, Harry. We will be right back after these messages.
We sure are. Contestants, it's time for scene four.
I love this time of year. No work and all football.
Yeah, the games are gonna start soon. Go Patriots.
What? No way! Go Bears!
Whatever, my team is better than your team.
Yeah. No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I love this time of year.
Yeah, this is what Christmas is all about.
Hey, let's go get some nachos.
Secret handshake.
Football!
Hey, save me some nachos. Sorry, I forgot where I was.
We will be right back.
We sure do, Sweaty. Contestants, time to take a look at the final scene.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord was all around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people.
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is a Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and an earth peace to whose on whom his favor rests."
So then the shepherds hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
This was the first Christmas. It was the birth of Jesus. Christmas is Jesus' birthday.
Contestants, are you ready?
Yes.
We are going to give you one more minute to decide which scene is the truth as we determine what is the true meaning of Christmas.
Do 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 bum.
Ow.
We're going to start with
Seriously, this is so simple. My final answer is shopping. It's all about the gifts. I can never have enough. That's why they call me Anita Moore.
That is incorrect.
I don't like this game show. I'd rather be shopping.
Contestant number two, Tom Manning. What is your answer?
My final answer is it's not about Santa Claus. It's not even about the gifts. It's about football! Yeah! Woo!
That is also incorrect.
But I love football.
Contestant number three, Honda Coin, what is your final answer?
Everyone, stop what you're doing and please listen. Christmas, it's not about Santa or the gifts or even hanging out with family. It's about Jesus and how he came as a baby and he sacrificed himself to pay for our sins. And now he lives in my heart as my Savior. Jesus is the reason for Christmas.
Let's give them a great big hand. Wow, 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 wow. Outstanding. They just amaze me every single time. What a great job. You know what? We are so thankful, so privileged that we were able to do that. You see some youth out there. Give our youth that helped us out a great big hand also. Yes. Tell you what, they did a great job. Also, back there on the sound, Jordan. Real quick, he doesn't like it, but Kerr Wayne, the man right there. Give him a great band. He told me he'd quit if I did that, but so pray. And then seriously, though, we may write these silly things and stuff like that, but every year I hand this certain person the play, and I say, make this happen and make this work. And she says, well, I guess I'm the director again. I said, yes, ma'am, you are. As long as I'm doing this, you're the director. Kelly right here. I can't go on enough. She makes this happen. The good Lord, she takes her deep breaths and deals with Kurt and I and the kiddos. And seriously, we can't thank you enough, Kelly, for all you do. Just amazing every single year. We're so honored to do this. You guys, we love these kids. Most of all, we love Jesus so much, and we just want to share the love of Jesus with these kids. Christmas, we get busy and we say a lot of silly things. We're not against any of those stuff, but we want to always go back to the main reason. Jesus is the reason for the season. So we're going to head on back, but as we do, give them one more great big hand. Oh, just a second. Uh-oh. The law's been laid. Get down here. Mike, you want this one? Here you go.
So, I've never really seen myself in a service. First of all, when you walked in, I said, I think that's mine. I said, Anna raided my closet and did not ask me. And then as we were looking, I'm like, that's my necklace. That's my earrings. And then I'm like, oh, you've got the little poof in your hair. Okay. Which I really like. It looks really good. But yeah, that really was a shocker. Yes, she had some preached to her. But I don't know if I should say you guys are making me look bougie, a little extra. Or what, but okay, yeah, that was funny. I was shocked, yeah. And Honda coin, yeah, that's funny. But I have to say, I think you should wear your hair like that all the time. But yeah, good one. But well done, you guys. We're super duper proud of you. And we want to say Merry Christmas to you guys, too. We're proud of the production you did, and just want to say that we love you very much and hope you have the best Christmas ever. Let's give them another hand. Seriously, that was funny. I had no clue. That was pretty good, and I think that's what I look like on Sundays. Wow. She did a really good job, didn't she? No, that was sweet. We appreciate the kids and Pastors Chad and Adrian doing that. Before we dismiss, we wanted to take a minute. You know, we're talking about Christmas and gifts, and last Sunday we did another gas card outreach, and we did this first back in July, and it was really cool. Trent and I were out here praying one day, and the Lord spoke to my heart about doing a gas card outreach where we just collect money for gas cards, and we go to different gas stations in Champaign, Urbana area, and the surrounding areas to just bless people by buying their gas. And so we did another round of those this past Sunday, and just had some awesome testimonies from that. And I asked Dan and Tina to come. There were several that went out all over Champaign, Urbana, Tolono, Mahomet, some different places. But they had some, we don't have time to hear from everybody, but I wanted them to share the experience that they had with some of the people.
Awesome. Well, we had a great time again. We thought we'd have a team of us going out, but it ended up just me and Tina. We had 15 cards. So we started out in Tolono, and evidently that Sunday, nobody needed gas. Everybody needed drinks. So we waited a half hour. We decided to move our location over to Urbana, Casey's over there, and that was a happening place. We found a lot of takers on the card, and it was a different environment than what we're used to. really stretched me, what I can say as far as my going out and speaking to people. And it was a really good time. We walked up to the first car. Tina had already walked up, and she was talking. We walked up to the car, and the lady rolled her window down, and we asked her, we said, can we bless you with a $50 gas card? And she pulled her hoodie over her face and just started bawling. And she had two little baby seats in the back seat with no babies in them, but we knew we could tell she would really needed the card. So she
got out of the car and just could not quit hugging us and crying. She couldn't get words to come out because she was crying so hard. The front of my shirt was just wet with tears because God was right on time as usual. So we got to pray with her and for her family, and then it kept us so busy to get those out because there's four lanes of gas pumps, and so we was busy running back and forth to each one. And we prayed for another lady who was very reluctant. She let the window come down a little bit, and I told her, I just want to let you know Jesus loves you. And through our church, we are blessing people with $50 gift cards for gas. And then she thought, well, okay. So she rolled the window down, and as I talked to her, I asked if I could pray with her, and she said, well, maybe. And she said, I'm just started kidney dialysis. So I got to pray with her for special healing. And we prayed with another man who said that we kind of got most of his story was his son had been attacked by a dog, and he felt it was his fault. And so we prayed with him, and it was so good. And then another car rolled up, and I walked over to the car, and the guy rolled down the window, and just like Cheech and Chong, all this smoke comes rolling out. But they were so receptive in their little party in the car. But they as Pastor had said earlier, we changed their focus. Their focus was no longer on what they had been doing, but they asked our names, they wanted prayer, they wanted to talk to us, and they couldn't move. They just sat in the car and kept talking amongst themselves, and Danny and I was running off to other cars, and he kept going, Danny and Tina, you're doing the work of God. And they were so blessed, and we were so blessed by all the people that we got to talk to. We only had three people not accept the cards. One lady was just like, no, I don't want no card. Then, you know, two other people, he said that he was from First Christian Church and was like, wow, you guys are doing a great thing here. And then we started on another car, and he ran up and goes, no, let me do it. So it's contagious, and we just had we were so blessed by the time we left. And it for 15 cards, it only took us an hour, but we prayed with so many people, and it was such a blessing. Midwest Believers is such a blessing to so many people.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing how God just shows up in a gas station. And the people were really, really receptive to us walking up to their car and not knowing what's going on. And it just really was a blessing. If you get a chance to do it, do it.
Do it. Do it.
Amen. Thank you, guys. That's just a few of what was experienced that day. And I think that's really cool. I want to commend you all for giving towards that, praying about it. And you know, if we would have just been there just offering prayer without anything, probably wouldn't have been able to pray with anybody. But have you ever noticed when you give people something, how that wall just seems to come down? And so I just think it's cool. To me, that's being the church, the hands and feet of Jesus. And the Lord has dealt with our hearts for next year just to continue that and make that a big focus as far as outreach. And not just organized outreaches. We're going to do that. There's some things stirring concerning that. But just as individuals within the church, taking what we have outside the walls of this church, we don't want to keep what we have just to ourselves. And so we're called to be the light in the hands and feet of Jesus. And this is just one simple way. And, you know, I think about the greatest gift of all, Jesus, that God loved us so much, he gave something. And so why not? The greatest example was set before us, and why not take that and go out and bless somebody? Amen. And so thank you to everybody that's gone out to do that. We're excited about what will happen in the coming year and expect God to move mightily. And, you know, we may not always personally see the results of it, but I believe one day in heaven, when we're standing before the throne of God, that somebody will walk up to us and say, hey, I received a gas card, and that changed my life. A seed was planted in their hearts, and especially in the world that we live in today, it's crazy. There's crazy stuff going on, and so for us to let people know there's still good people in the world and that Jesus loves them, I mean, what better way to be a light? Amen. And so thank you to everybody, and sorry we couldn't share all the testimonies. There were so many, but we just wanted to share a few of those so that you could see, guys, we're making a difference in our community. So, you know, thank you. Thank you for being a part. We're a team. It's not just us. It's us as a whole. Teamwork. Amen.
Amen. You know, I just wanted to say this about next year. We're going to talk a lot about, probably start the year off talking about outreach, but not just doing outreaches. But, you know, you have something on the inside of you that can change somebody's life. Amen. And we talk about the gift, and you know, all that came because, you know, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave. You know, we're all Christians, and somebody might say, well, you have to give them something for them to pray with you, or you have to give them something for them, you know, to open that door. Yeah. And that's how we all came into the kingdom, because God so loved the world that he gave. He gave us freedom that we didn't deserve. And, you know, people pulling up, they're going through their day, boom, 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 you know, and they're doing their thing, but they encounter Jesus at the gas pump. You say, no, they encountered me. Yeah, that's what I said. They encountered Jesus at the gas pump. And you may be the only Jesus that they ever come in contact with, but you are all the Jesus that they need. What is in you is what they need. And so I want to encourage you. You know, this next year, this isn't something that is by the calendar. It's something that we can always do. But we're going to, as a church, focus on being the church, being the outreach. Amen. Not just doing outreaches, and those are great, but being available when something in your heart says, go ahead and do this, go ahead and do it. Something in your heart says, pray for this one, you go ahead and do it. You don't have to wait for an announcement. Hey, in 3 weeks, we're going to get together, and as a church, we're going to go out, and we're going to do this, we're going to do that. No. When nobody else is around, no church people are around, there's not an outreach planned or whatever, but there's just something in your heart, and I want you to have the confidence to say, okay, I'll do it. I'll pray for that one. I'll share my testimony with that one. I'll find out what's going on. Or maybe it's financial. Maybe you have something in your heart. Well, I'll pay for their groceries. I'll do this. I'll do that. What is that? Being yielded to God. And God knows, just like each one of us, he knew how to reach us. He knows how to reach them. Amen. And you know what's awesome? We get to be a part of that. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, God is good. Amen. Amen. So faithful. So faithful. Everybody bow your heads and close your eyes. Father, we thank you. We praise you for your goodness and your faithfulness. And Lord, you gave Jesus, your son, to die on the cross for each one of us. And pay the price for sin in our lives. We thank you for that. If there's anybody in the room, you say this, you say, I need to make Jesus the Lord of my life. Maybe you've never made that decision. Maybe you've never prayed this prayer. Or maybe you've prayed this prayer before, but you've walked away from the relationship with God. And you say, today's the day. I want to make this new, this fresh decision. And I want to ask Jesus to come into my heart. Amen. Hallelujah. If that's you, I just ask everybody to pray with me, whether you're in the room or out on Facebook and you're watching. Say this, say, Jesus, thank you for loving me. I believe you died on the cross for me. I believe that your blood was spilled out for me. For the sin that I had incurred in my life, I believe you paid the price for that. You took the punishment for that. I believe you died on the cross for me. I believe you went to hell for me. I believe that God raised you from the dead. Thank you for loving me. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Say this. Say, I'm a child of God. Everything's good between me and him because of the blood of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Altar care team, if you go ahead and come on up. We're going to close the services this morning. And if you need prayer, if you know, I say this all the time, but please do not leave here not having prayer. Please do not leave here and think, man, I'm really going through this. I'd sure like to have prayer. I'd sure like to have someone agree with me. Don't leave service. That's what the prayer team is here for. The altar care workers are there to meet you. So as we close the service, they're going to stay up here for a little bit and agree with you and pray with you. Amen? Amen. Father, we thank you and we praise you. Thank you for your goodness and your faithfulness to each one of us. We just declare that each family is blessed during this season, that the families represented here are blessed. They're increasing. They're coming up to a higher place in you in every area of their lives. I thank you for these kids that ministered today and just shared this this program with us. Father God, I thank you for blessing them. I thank you for your protection. In Jesus' name, we give you praise and we give you thanks.